Yawa. Are you still there? We had got carried to the sunlight at the forehead, drove back to us yesterday.
I'm sorry, my queen. I wanted to be sure we did not forget anything.
Forget? When has Zoya come to forgetting things at the stream? May not my save me from such.
But I'm sure you did not see what I saw.
And what was that you saw that Oya did not?
I saw something tender and beautiful.
What is that?
A flower.
A flower? You can't be serious.
Yeah, it is, my queen.
Oh, my heart beats with excitement. But come, Mariwa. How come I didn't see this before now?
I don't know. Perhaps it's the way Olodumare wants it.
The flower. But, could that have gone here?
Do you doubt your daughter, my queen?
Not really, my precious. I was only wondering how this tender child of nature could have emerged from this rocky part of the stream.
The works of Olodumare are always amazing.
Yes, amazing works, very well. But still, this is strange. And it's so soft, tender, and beautiful. Like the chick that has just been cut.
But not as beautiful as my queen.
Arewa.
As of a woman in whose presence men of courage and will tremble. A woman of great legends and sheer irresistibility.
Arewa! Let me think.
I'm sorry, my queen.
And who saw this?
You saw this?
Yes, I did.
Where, my queen?
In my dream. One of the dreams I had of late.
Your dream?
Yes. I saw this that night, Arewa. I saw this the night we were honored with dances. And the strong arms of Ogoni and my husband held to me like never before. I was lost in the euphoria of our union as I clung to my husband as if the day was not going to break anymore. For some moment, I fell asleep. I found myself in a strange land where the women danced. Their leader held a beautiful flower which attracts everyone's attention. I especially was captivated by its beauty. The feeling was simply irresistible. Arewa, stop the dance!
I was moved, my queen, I'm sorry.
I think there is a message in this for me. I shall keep this as a special gift from Orisha, okay? Hurry up! Let us go.
My lord must hear this. Again. Stop the drums. What has come over you?
I tried to remember everything. I tried to remember all the movement.
With those awkward steps of yours like some duck in water.
I'll do better next time.
Listen to the drums. Relax your mind. And let your mind accompany the beat. And you will see yourself flowing along like a river. Now you watch me.
I have seen a blessing from Oloku, the best any man has ever seen.
Rest now, Miro. Why do you shout so loud like a squirrel in a hunter's trap?
I am sorry, my lord. I could not keep my excitement on hold.
Your bed has come to its roots now. Relax like a sensible messenger. Deliver the message.
My lord, I need to be excited because of her.
Huh?
Yes, I saw her at the stream.
You saw who?
The most beautiful woman I've ever seen.
A beautiful woman?
Yes. She must be from the house of beauty and elegance. From the household of Oloku.
Ha! Dreams. How you amaze people. Could she be the one I've been seeing in my dreams of late? Could she be the reason why my father Oromio has been talking to me about this one? Could she be? Omiro, where did you say you saw her?
The path to the stream, my lord.
And you know where she lives?
Yes. She lives near the hills after the footpath of the outskirts of the land.
Does she live alone? I mean without the protection of any man.
Yes. No, I don't think so, my
lord. Does she live alone or not?
I saw with a young girl. I guess she
does he live alone or not?
With a husband?
Answer me!
I don't know, my lord.
We shall then pay her a visit in her house.
Okay. Excuse me, father.
What is it?
But you promised me you won't marry another woman after my mother's death.
What does a small child like you know about marriage?
You promised me, father. You promised me another woman.
Shut up! Wherever the Asha sent his arrow, there it goes. I take decision in this house, and not you.
But,
one more word from you there, and I'll cut your head off. Omiya, let us go.
Oh, my knees again, father of children. Please do bless me this time.
I told you your misfortune is not in my making. Why hanging your guilt over my neck, Oya?
It is not so, Barisa. When a woman stays too long in the house of her husband, without a child, she equally becomes a man. Yet, I know your backyard is populated with as many children as a woman can desire. Just one will definitely make Oya happy.
The brooks does not get dry, even in dry season. Even as my hands are wet, as I discharge my duties, but church is not one of them.
Ah, Usire Mokbo, Oshawuji, don't forsake your daughter. Save me now, father of children.
How can a humble servant take credit skills of his master? How can I?
Please bless me now, Batosha. Bless Oya now for good.
I thought I told you the last time we met together. It's 3 full moons now.
I traveled for Obarisa. I traveled to Koro. There they said my children are not. They said in your hands is my answer to becoming a mother. They said in your backyard is.
That's not what they meant. Anyway, I commend your effort. But what you seek for is done yet. You have to forge ahead.
Is that what you say to console your daughter?
Your part is being woven with a lot of mystery.
Mystery? What do you mean, father of children?
You make as if you've never heard that before. I thought they told you on your sojourn. What is the essence of the journey and back on them?
Mystery? Can it be? Does it have anything to do with my dream?
Your dreams? What dreams? How did it go?
It was one sunny day after I returned from my journey. My husband was still at the battlefront. In my moment of solitude, I fell asleep. They all came to me, dressed in white, with glittering crowns adorning their heads. In their hands were wise, amazing old stills. All of them, Alara, Ajiru, Oluyemoyi, Untagiolele, and Owaragwaga. Instead of wiping my tears, they placed on my laps a riddle. Wipe your tears, Oya. Cast your gaze in the sky. When the clouds becomes dark and misty, conjure your spirit of whirlwind, and in the midst of lightning you shall find your happiness. I wanted to ask them what they meant, but my lips just couldn't move. I woke up feeling heavy all over, and the dream has become confusing ever since.
Wipe your tears now, go home, Oya.
Go home? What about my desire for children?
Don't think about children now. You have something great ahead of you. That's what they meant.
I have a task ahead of me. What do you mean, father of children?
I don't know. Go home now, Oya.
Don't send me away, father of children.
I'm not sending you away.
But you make the riddle more gray and confusing by refusing to explain it to me. You make everything more difficult by your silence over it.
Not that, Oya Ori.
Then loosen the knotty thread and lift the button off my chest.
Go to the father of wisdom.
I shall do that.
Go quickly, Oya.
I thank you for your trouble.
Who is here? I say, who is here? My lord Anababi, Shongo, son of Romeo, Dadure, send his greetings.
Must you shout so loud?
Oh, sorry. I don't know someone was at the yelling.
And where did you come from, Kushina?
From the courtyard of the powerful one.
The powerful one? Who?
Shongo, Anababi, son of Romeo, Dadure.
Oh, I see. What's your name?
I am Omiro.
Omiro, is that so?
Yes, young woman. I am from a proud lineage of praise singers. And my father was the son to the royal brand. And whose own grandfather was a palace jester. And whose own grandfather was a bright singer of tales.
That sounds really important. Well, what's your work?
I am my lord's special messenger.
Your lord's special messenger? With such amazing ancestral credentials. Oh, you still run errands?
Errands? Young woman, you're missing it. Don't you know it's another way of boasting the ancestral credentials, if you ask?
Oh, I guess that's much. You should be ashamed of being son El's errand boy at your age.
Don't belittle my love with your untuttered tongue, young man. Don't you know it is an honor to have a powerful and courageous man?
How do you run like that in my house? My husband, Ogunire, is the most powerful, courageous, and special of all men.
Ah! The masquerade entered the playing game. Beautiful one. My lord's saying is greeting.
What is your lord?
What? That is rather undignified way of talking to my master.
Well, who is your lord?
Songwara Babi, son of Arumiyo, Dajure.
So, why are you here?
My lord sent me a special message to you.
What message has he that he sent you passing like a dog that has just escaped from the lion's den?
Well, he said his hand of friendship is extended to the beautiful one.
Oh, that is great though. But tell Shongo that the wife of Onire does not flirt with strangers.
Strangers? Since I know you, and I know where my master can see you, you shall not be any stranger then.
Don't you dare bring anyone there, you messenger. And listen again. None man trains the jungle carelessly. Hells, he's straight into the den of the king of the jungle.
The same jungle has other animals equally deserving honor, beautiful woman. Besides, Shongo Arabambi has no king. He's king himself.
Some kings are mightier than some others.
A king like Shongo will send fears down the heart of any other king.
You glorify in rainbows, Shongo. If your butterfly imitates a bird, it will end up having its beautiful appearance turned into shreds.
You sound full of courage. Besides, I can't remember Omino telling me your name.
What does the so-called king have to do with my name?
Familiarity, at least. The first step to knowing one another.
I know my husband, Obunire, and my dutiful maid, Arewa. They are more important to me than anyone else.
Oh, easy, good woman. I come as a friend and not an enemy.
You should have come on my invitation then. My home is never open to ambitious intruders.
I will leave then. But will you do well to tell me your name?
I am Oya Oriri.
Oya Oriri? That sound twisting like a whirlwind.
What did you say?
I mean your name can move any man, as your beauty does.
The tree that produces good flowers, ask someone who waters it. My husband is blessed then.
There's no way a chimpanzee does, that a monkey cannot.
The chimpanzee is not tired of its acrobats. The monkey's act becomes unnecessary.
Arambambi desires a woman of great pride and beauty. And I will want to make you my wife.
You make me laugh, Shongo. I thought you came to take a piece of food or fire from my fire. I'm surprised you came to look into the pot of my soup.
The aroma of your pot of soup is irresistible that any man will want to have a taste of it.
You make a mistake, Shongo. No other man romances the wife of the lion.
Even if it costs me to face the lion in the right thick jungle, and I will.
You will fail this time, Shongo.
Not when the blood of Oromiyo runs through me.
You may take your leave.
Why are you suddenly becoming unfriendly?
I said you may leave.
I will, but we shall see again. Omiro, let's go.
I'm not ever come back here again, no.
Better days lie ahead already.
Then what must I do?
Patience. It is not the day a child is born that it starts to run. Everything takes time.
I shall wait, Baba.
Tell my visitor to come in.
Okay, Baba. Thank you.
Old one, the wisest messenger of Olodumare, I know you for your presence.
Oh yeah. Wife of Onire, you look radiant still, and your beauty grows on, even as you grow with age.
Thank you, wise one.
But this charming face looks troubled too.
It is true the red necklace that nods constantly. Yet all is not well. Save me, Father of Wisdom.
Your husband Ogun is annoyed with you again?
Not this time, wise one. Ogun and I don't quarrel anymore. Like babies, we have outgrown the problems of teething.
Then what is the problem?
Anya is only full of beauty. Nothing more to show that she is a real woman.
Oh, you make me laugh. Woman of Onire. Of course. A woman who wants to have a child does not close her house. She opened them.
It is not my fault, wise one. Is it possible to shave someone's head in his absence? What do I do when my husband hardly stays at home?
At least, you're also aware of his obsession for war.
There should be a way out of this. When the spirit takes away something for a man, they give back something as a replacement.
What do you mean?
Talk to Ifa. iwaju opon ife ogbon eyin opon ife ogba olumo oro tun olumo lo si arin ife opon itan opon ma fi bi pere ma fi re pe bi bo ba ti ri ni oju o. If I speak with Ridu, and if I sings, you understand it already.
Break the kernel of your proverb. Let me swallow the sense of fruit in it.
To stand and drink the water from a well is difficult. This task is difficult, Oya.
Losing the note for the wise one.
Yes, Oya. You have to be on your tune and prepare for the next task.
There is yet another one. You scare me, wise one.
There is another one. Wish your faith be manifested.
My faith? What do you mean?
Oh yeah. Go now and prepare for your task.
But wise one.
Go now, Oya. There is no time.
Thank you, wise one.
Don't be afraid of this woman. She's nice and go around
it. She scared me.
But I thought you are bold at heart.
You're not ashamed to have willed an helpless woman. I don't get started for this part.
Ashamed? What has shame got to do with two people that are in love?
Don't ride on Vain or Shungo. Oya is not in love with you. To be on my way.
Wait a minute. Arabambi does not play with his dream. Unless it comes to fulfillment. I shall take my leave now.
Wait. Ah, let me tell you my own dream. Oh, it's gone already. Dreams. Ah, this riddle again.
What are you doing here? Walk gently. Bring him down. Put him down gently. Put him down gently, I say, you fool. Get me some alupaida and baby leave. Yes, my lord. And let's be strong here.
Hiya, my lord.
You stay by him. Let's go. And you, come. Why did you lead your soldiers under your command towards the river?
I'm sorry, my lord.
You are sorry. You are a fool. You think your foolishness will win the battle? No. We are ticks and tacks, man.
We try to kill the powerful man and we succeed.
You try to kill the powerful man and we succeed. By making fool of yourself. Huh? So Duroku, I always tell you, whenever you are at the battlefront, when you send some men, let there always be some men for backup. See, let me tell you, war is meant for quick-minded people, not for fool like you. Get away from me.
I'm sorry, my lord.
You are sorry.
That will not happen next time.
Oh, it will not.
My heart sleeps for joy. I see myself dancing so with the more guardian of people. Ogo Onire. I welcome you after all this while.
Oh yeah, really. My precious drop. It is good to be back home. And I'm home for good.
No more what you mean? No more business at the battlefront.
Not for now, Oya.
It is good news. I just hope this is for real. And I hope we can truly live to justify the dreams we both shared on our wedding night.
What do you mean?
Nothing, my lord and husband.
Nothing? It is rather unusual you speak to me this way. Talk to me, Oya.
It seems so, but there is no sense.
Then why speak in twisted tongues? Talk to me, Oya.
The bird seeks it to understand the language of the day, so it skips nights at the vigil.
Oh. I thought the trees near the river understand the language of the fishes.
As if you understand, man.
Of course, woman, I will.
I'm only wondering for how long Oya will continue to wait.
Wait? For what? Talk to me, Oya. What are you scared of?
I'm scared of everything.
But you don't have to.
I have to, my husband. Etrida doesn't know how to dance, they say. We'll be taught by the wind.
Etrida doesn't know how to dance. We'll be taught by the wind.
Yes, my lord. I only hope the wind that will blow this time will be a certain one.
Oh yeah, you confuse me with all this talk of yours. You know, one start a dance gently. So talk to me, Oya.
Everyone knows that to have a good harvest, one must plant very well.
Of course, I know.
The only farmland there is Oya. So begin to plant your seed right and now.
Oh, the reason for the video. Ogun, we face the tax like the good farmer and the good soldier that I am. Come closer, Oya.
Oh yeah, Riri, my precious queen, you look more beautiful now.
Really?
Seriously, Olokun has endowed you with more beauty during my absence.
Not only Olokun, but my mother, Yemotele Rudo.
I bless them as well.
But I wonder if you could have noticed any other special thing in Olokun. When you hardly stay at home, when the law of the battleground overwhelms everything.
Oh yeah. Don't bring this up again. I told you, I'm home for good. And that should be the most important thing to us now.
But that has not solved any problem here.
Oh, Batala has not stopped performing his duty. Oh, Lord Umari will definitely bless us with children in twos and three. And after all, you'll be the one tired of their demands and whisper.
What that will happen when you're always at the battleground? When I roll alone on a mat? When my gates are wide up open, but the man in the house is nowhere to be found? Is that when Obatala's efforts will be justified and Olodumare's blessings of my own will be done?
Why all this unnecessary emotion, Oya?
Leave those words alone. Come closer to me, my husband. Do you understand me?
Well, you understand me first. As a soldier, I have my own duty to perform.
Duty?
Yes, to protect my people.
What is that, my husband? What is it? What is wrong with my husband? Just shake my head, the same place on my hand.
What approaches are there?
Not again.
My lord, our men are waiting. So, Sodiroku, summon our men. Get them ready. They must not enter our territory. You go now.
I go, my lord.
I must go.
You must kiss my bed tonight, Zogun.
There is no use for this now, my queen. The leopard has left already.
Did you say? I won't go back to the house. Not for any reason.
What do you mean?
The beats have changed. The dance step have equally changed. Or are you afraid?
Afraid? Of who?
Of Moniri, my former husband, of course.
When the sword sees the battle, it rejoices. Arabambi will never be afraid of anyone.
What do you do with this?
Oh, this. This is Ose. It was given to me by my forefathers.
Do you use it for?
What do I use it for? Do anyone need to ask what the lion uses its claws for? Or what the snake uses its fang for? For so many things.
Really?
Whenever I hold it with passion, the sky rumble with thunder of claps.
Hey, I like the idea of it conjuring the thunder.
Hope you are not doubting my words.
No. What if I summon the rains?
Summon the rains? How can you do that?
I can't do that. I am Oya Oriri. The ring is at my fingertips.
Are you really sure you can do that?
Yes. Rest will save the sky while I do my work. It's very well. On tomorrow.
What is that, my lord? Ose has spoken. Oya has done it. Son of Bajure. Bajure! You shall follow me now. Omiron, speak to my ears.
Shango! Okoya! Arabambi Okoya!
Oya! Where is Oya? Where is that woman that thinks she can abandon my house and go in search of one silly love?
My lord, Onire.
And you, Arewa?
I was not involved in this.
Caesar!
I tried to stop her. I tried to...
Oh, oh.
So Shango that came to took her away.
Ah, Shango? Shango did what?
Yes, yes, my lord.
How dare Shango come into my own territory and take what belongs to me? Oh, the battle line has been...
But I have something in mind.
What?
I heard that Oya go between the two warriors of our people. Make sure. See, the war is going to take place in 3 days now. Yes, at the market square. See, I have to go. Because the war will be tough. I mean, see, the two warriors.
Father of wisdom, you also heard the war between Ogun and Sango over all your living.
Oh, Barisha, nobody tell the dumb that the rain is falling. No one tell the deaf that the market is over. The news is everywhere.
Shame indeed. This shame must end.
It must end. What's come after the progress? Where is Shango? Where is that?
I am here!
Oh! Stop this rubbish!
Why stop me now? Let me show this useless fool a lesson.
I would have sucked you and your stupid pride into
oh, me. Now you can boast.
Why should I have not done this?
I love Ogun fiercely, passionately. I would open my heart. But you chose to put my emotion on the ground. And I promise that, as fiercely as I love him, will I throw him and his overrated devil into the mud.
I bet you satisfied your useless desire now. And for doing that, you won no honors.
The honor is nothing. At least, I've gotten my pride back.
It's of no good use.
Not in your life.
Enough of this.
Oh, fine. I shall go back to my father's land. Where peace reign.
My lord.
What?
Please, let us go with you, my lord.
No, you shall stay here to protect the people of this land.
Okay, my lord.
I will also take my leave.
Hope you happy now. I'm taking my leave.
I am off to go.
I shall follow you. I shall go with you. No, 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 you stay here. You must learn to live alone.
Let us go.
And dear special messenger. Yeah. Where is your house?
I live at the Selwood Rivers.
No problem. Well, it's my pleasure.
Aya yami yami oh hey oh yeah. Aya yami yami oh hey oh yeah.
I play the role of Atala, a female that female that taught the man.
Where is this place called? I feel like, you know, doing a little good stunt, like.
The moment is okay, and thank God it's a peaceful place. Then, the only thing that I meant is also to rest, which is very rough. And my lecturer in charge, Dr. Doctor, who came to check on me yesterday? Oh, thank you. Visit.
When they give me that umbrella, I thought I can't do this. Well, when I see my picture, I say, ah, mind your own, bro. I can't go, sha. Bro, it's not easy, sha, bro. I can't go, man. It's peaceful. We reckoned, we limited with those that are they are friendly people. Now she's talking about it. Yeah, but I really group leader, also called the director, sha. My lecturer, Dr. Lou, was here yesterday and he was here today too. I'm sure if everything is going on. I didn't get a gun.